He's the God, and beside Him there is no other God. He's the only God that have omnipotent power.
Right.
He's the only God that is omniscient. He's the only God that is omnipresent. So wherever you go, Jesus is always there with you.
Amen.
You never, never, never alone.
Never alone.
Because of the power of an almighty God.
All right.
I'm Minister Bellows from Huntville Church, 15640 River Road. We would like to invite you to our Easter service at 10 o'clock a.m. April the 21st. We would love to have you there.
Vision of Faith, the television ministry dedicated to bringing you the Word of God from today's local ministries. If you're searching for the truth, look no further. Let's go in now and find out who's bringing the Word of God this week on Vision of Faith.
Hello, my name is Anthony Bellow. I'm the pastor of Huntville Church, located at 15640 River Road in Huntville, Louisiana. The phone number is 985-308-1425. Today I will be preaching from Psalm 23, the seven redemptive names of Christ. Father, we just praise you this morning. Because God, you are our wonderful counselor, our mighty God, our everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. We ask you, dear God, to forgive us for all our sins and trespasses. And God, that you would take our sins and cast them as far as the east is from the west, never to remember them anymore. We thank you, dear God, for life, because God, you are the giver of our existence. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for being the Lord and the Master of our lives. And we thank you, dear God, for being here. God, we welcome you this morning in your house of prayer.
Oh, yes.
And we thank you, dear God, for being our Savior. We pray, dear God, that you would bless the people that's here, God. Lord, that you would bless them coming in and that you would bless them going out. We thank you, dear God, for being our great physician. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for being the God of our salvation. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. This morning I want to talk to you about seven redemptive names of Christ. And that's found in Psalm 23. You may be seated. Psalm 23 is the most preached psalm out of the 150 psalm. It is found in book 1, the book of Genesis. David is telling us what God has been for him, and what God is doing on his behalf. So the first verse is, "The Lord is my shepherd." The Lord is my shepherd is a Hebrew word which means Yahweh Roha. And that means that the Lord, that the word Lord is the proper name of the God of Israel. It's a word so holy that the Israelite did not even pronounce his name. And that word means the one bringing into being, the life giver, the giver of existence, a covenant God, a God that is unchangeable, the God that is ever coming into manifestation, a God that is the deliverer and safety and our welfare.
Amen.
Well, David is saying, the Lord is my shepherd. God is self-consistent. He's God all by himself.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
There is no other God beside the living and true God.
Amen.
In the book of 1 Kings, chapter 8, verse 60, that Solomon was dedicating the temple, and Solomon said that all the people of the earth may know that the Lord, in all capital letters, that the Lord is God and that there is none else.
Amen.
God is the only God. The only living and true God.
Yes, yes.
And he has the power to do whatever he wants to do.
Right.
He is omnipotent. He is omniscient. He is omnipresent. There's nothing that God cannot do. In the book of John, Jesus said six things about the shepherd. He said, they know their shepherd. We know our shepherd, and our shepherd is Jesus.
Amen.
And he said, in John chapter 10, he said, they know his voice. Well, you know, prayer is really talking about Jesus is talking about us praying to God, and Jesus, and we hear the word of the Lord, and Jesus talking to us.
Amen.
They hear him calling them by name. We, God, hear us calling him by name.
Amen.
And we love him, we trust him, and we follow him. In order for you to be a sheep.
Yes, yes.
The Bible says that one must feel like a sheep.
Yes.
The second one is God. We have to have a testimony about what God has done for us.
Amen.
We have to testify about the godly care that God has done for the church.
Yes, yes.
Third thing is that we must be willing to follow God, to follow the Lord. And so David said, the Lord is my shepherd, Yahweh Roha.
Amen.
And he said, I shall not want.
Yes.
Jesus is Jehovah Jireh.
Yes,
he is our provider.
Yes, yes.
And the Bible said he supplied all our needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus.
Yes, man.
The Bible said that Jesus not only provide food, shelter, and clothing, but Jesus have the power to give you what you want.
Amen. Yes.
He have the power to give you the desires of your heart.
Yes.
He provides food, remnant, health, breath, and strength.
Yes, Lord.
Everything comes from God.
Everything.
In the book of Mark chapter 4 verse 39, the Bible says, and he arose, and he rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, peace, be still. And that was a great calm. You know what Jesus was saying?
What?
Jesus was saying to the wind, hush up.
Amen.
Hush up.
Yes.
Be quiet and be muzzled.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Jesus has power over nature.
Yes. Yes.
So he provides everything that we need in our life.
Yes, yes.
The Bible says, no good things will he withhold from them that walk uprightly.
Amen.
God have the power to give you exactly what you need if you put your trust in him. He said, Lord shall open unto you his good treasure.
Good treasure.
And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath.
Yeah.
If that thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God.
Yeah.
Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Yes. Yes.
And all these things shall be added unto you.
Amen.
Food, shelter, and clothing.
Yes.
And he said, if you delight yourself in me, then I'm going to give you the desires of your heart. There is nothing that God cannot do.
Yes, yes.
Then David said, he make me to lie down in green pastures and lead me beside still waters. You see, sheep do not drink in one running water. David is really saying that the Lord is Jehovah Shalom.
Amen.
He is the God of peace.
Yes.
And the Bible tells us that peace, that is what you call an abundant peace.
Abundant peace.
The Bible said in Psalm 119 verse 65, great peace have they which love thy law.
Yes.
And nothing shall offend them.
Amen.
Then the Bible tells you in Isaiah chapter 26 and verse 3. And they have what you call a perfect peace.
Yes, sir.
It said, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusted in the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
Then the Bible said that peace, the peace of God, is like a river.
Yes, yes.
In the book of Isaiah chapter 48 and verse 18, the scripture said, oh, that thou had hearkened unto my commandment, then had thy peace been as a river, and thy righteousness as the waves of the sea. Yes. Jesus said in John 14 and 27, he said, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you.
Amen.
Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
Oh, yeah.
The word trouble right there is the Greek word called tarasso.
All right.
And it means that you do not let your heart go into convulsion.
Hold on. Oh, yeah.
He said, I have the power to bring peace in your life.
Amen.
Because you see, peace is a gift of the Holy Spirit.
Oh, yes.
Nobody can give you peace unless you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Because the Holy Spirit is the only one that can bring peace in the midst of a storm.
Yes.
It's the only one that can bring peace in your heart. Then David said, He restores my soul.
Oh, yes.
He said, He restores my soul.
Yes.
Jesus is our Jehovah Rapha.
All right.
He's the God that have the ability to heal your bodies and to heal your soul.
Hallelujah.
Didn't he bring Lazarus back from the dead?
Yes.
He brought Lazarus back from the dead, and Lazarus had been dead for 4 days.
Yes, he did.
He says, Lazarus, come forth.
All right.
And Lazarus came forth.
Amen.
But the Bible is saying that Jesus, the Lord, have the power to renew your life.
Yes.
He's the power that can revive your life.
Oh, yeah.
He's the power that can bring back your dead body back to life.
Yes.
He causes my life to return or be renewed. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 53 and verse 5, the Bible says he was wounded for our transgressions.
Yes. Yeah.
He was bruised for our iniquity.
Amen.
The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we have already been healed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In Jeremiah chapter 30 verse 17, the Bible says, And for I will restore health unto thee.
Yes.
And I will heal thee of thy wounds, said the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Then the Bible says in Psalm 109, verse 20 and 21.
Oh, yeah.
He said, He sent His word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. He said, Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness and for His wonderful works to the children of men. You know why God healed you by it?
Yeah.
Because God healed you in order for you to testify about His goodness.
Amen.
He said, when God heals your body, you need to stand up and tell the world that God is a healer.
All
and
right.
He has the power to heal. All He has to do is send His word.
Yes.
And heal you and deliver you from your destruction.
Oh, yes.
Then the Bible tells us in Psalm 103, verses 1, 2, and 3. It said, bless the Lord, O my soul.
Yes.
And if you look in your Bible, you're going to see the word Lord in all capital letters.
Yes.
And that is the word Yahweh.
Yes, Lord.
That's a God that is self-sufficient. He don't need anybody else. He's the only living and true God. He said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. He said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Who forgive all your iniquities and who heal all your diseases. God is Jehovah Rapha.
Oh, yes.
He's the God that have the ability, the power to be able to heal your body.
All right.
You need to tell the Lord every once in a while. You need to raise your hands in the air as a sign of submission. Because Jesus did the same thing. He raised His hand in the air. And He said, God, I thank You.
Yes.
I thank You, my Father, because I know that You have the power to turn that bread to feed 5,000 men and women.
Amen.
Every once in a while, you have to let God know that you need Him.
Yes,
and because without the Lord, nobody can do anything. You need God all the time. You need the Lord. L-O-R-D in all capital letters.
Yes.
Which means that God is the only living and true God. There is no other God that have the power to do what God is able to do with your body. All you have to do is have faith in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And if you don't have great faith, you can ask the Lord to increase the little bit of faith that you have. And all you need is a faith as a grain of mustard seed. Then God is going to begin to work miracles in your life.
Oh, yes.
Then the Bible says, He lead me in path of righteousness. Jesus is Jehovah Tishkenu.
All right. Lord.
He's Jehovah Tishkenu.
All right now.
Amen.
He's the God of righteousness.
Yes.
We have no righteousness on our own.
That's right.
But our righteousness come from Jesus. Because Jesus has all righteousness come from the Lord. The Bible says, righteousness art thou, O Lord.
Yes,
Jeremiah 12 and verse 1. Then the Bible tell us in Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 6. In his days, Judah shall be saved.
Yes.
And Israel shall dwell safely.
All right.
And this is the name whereby he shall be called.
All right.
The Lord our righteousness.
Yeah.
And that is Yahweh Tishkenu.
All right.
Yeah.
Whenever you see the word Lord in all capital letters,
all right,
that means the word, that Hebrew word is Yahweh. He's the God, and besides him, there is no other God. He's the only God that have omnipotent power.
Right.
He's the only God that is omniscient. He's the only God that is omnipresent. So wherever you go, Jesus is always there with you.
Amen.
You're never alone.
Never.
Because of the power of an almighty God.
All right.
The Bible said the eyes of the Lord,
yes,
are open unto the righteous.
Yes, yes.
And his ears are open unto that cry.
Yes.
So when you begin to pray to God,
yes, Lord.
When you begin to call on the name of Jesus,
yes,
he's right here waiting to answer your prayer.
Yes,
you know why? Because you belong to the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible said, but as many as received Jesus, to them gave he power to become sons or daughters of Christ.
Yes.
He's always there waiting to hear from you.
Yes.
Because as you pray to God, he prays back to you.
All right.
Because that is prayer. Prayer is talking to God and God talking back to you.
Amen.
It's a communication,
yes,
between God and man.
All right.
It's a dialogue between two people that are in love with one another.
All right.
That's what prayer is. The church talking to God, or even the sinner talking to God, and God talking back to you.
All right.
Listen to what Psalm 145 verse 17 says. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, and holy in all his work. When you read the Bible, you need to look at the words in that Bible.
Yes, sir.
Because the word here is L, capital L, capital O, capital R, and capital D.
Yes,
which is the great, the name of God is really Yahweh.
All right.
He's the only living and true God.
All right.
He is a performer of his promises. And there is nothing that's too hard or too difficult for God to do.
Glory.
Then he sent his word and healed my head.
Yes.
God is a healer.
Yes,
he has the power to say, the power to tell the wind, shut up,
yes,
be quiet, and be muzzled.
Hallelujah.
He has the power to send his word,
yes,
and to heal your physical body.
All right.
He has the power to send your word, yes, and to heal your spiritual body.
Amen.
That's how powerful God is.
Yes.
There is no other God beside the living and true God.
Hallelujah.
All our righteousness, the Bible says, oh, it's filled to rags.
Yes.
But the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all our sins.
Oh, yes.
Jesus had to die in order that we might become his children. And his blood is required because we need the blood of Jesus,
yes, we do,
to be able to claim salvation. Then the scripture said, he is with me in the valley.
All right.
Yes,
Jesus is with us in the valley.
In the valley. Hallelujah.
Jesus is Jehovah Shammah.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
The Lord is there.
Yes.
In the book of Ezekiel, I tell you that Ezekiel chapter 48, verse 435, that God is Jehovah Shammah.
All right.
That he is omnipresent.
Oh, yes.
Right now.
And you cannot escape the presence of the Lord.
That's right.
The Bible tells us in Psalm 139, starting at verse 7. He said, whither shall I go from thy spirit?
Yeah.
Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, God, you there.
Yes.
If I make my bed in hell, yes, behold, thou art there.
Yes.
If I take the wings of the morning, yes, and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, yes, and thy right hand shall hold me.
Amen.
If I say, surely darkness shall cover me,
yes,
even night shall be light to God.
All right.
Lightness, darkness, and light is the same thing from God.
Oh, yeah.
So therefore, at night, when you're doing all kind of things, you think that nobody see you, God has omniscient eye.
Oh, yeah.
He's everywhere at the same place,
oh, yeah,
at the same time. Yeah. Because God is omnipresent.
Yes, he is.
You cannot escape the presence of the Lord.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
Then David uses another Hebrew word.
All right.
He said, another covenant word for God. He said, he prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. I remember when God told his people. He said, you see the people that's here? All your enemies. He said, look at them for the last time. Because of the fact that you shall see those people no more.
No more.
You know what the Lord does? The Lord is the one that fights your battle.
Yes, yes, he does. Yes.
He is Jehovah Sabaoth.
Yes,
he's
yes,
the God that takes yes, to stand still and see the salvation yes, of the Lord.
All right.
That's all you have to do yes, is stand still.
Amen.
Because the Lord is the one. He's the Lord of the stars.
Yeah.
He's the Lord of his people.
Yeah.
And he has the power yeah, to command his angel to come yeah, and to destroy 185,000 yeah, enemies at one time.
All right.
That's what God does.
Yeah.
Then David said, he prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Jesus is Jehovah Nissi.
Yeah. All right.
The Lord our banner, or the Lord our victory.
All right.
The Bible says in Romans 8:38, but I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
He said, no, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Jesus is our victory.
Yes.
He is Jehovah Nissi. He is our banner. Oh, he is our victory.
All right.
And victory come in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
As you serve the Lord, God will show you that there is no enemy that come your way
oh, yes,
that is not able to get rid of.
Yes, Lord. Oh,
and he said in 2 Corinthians 2:14,
yes,
the Bible says, yes. Yes. Jesus always calls us to triumph. Yes. He's our victory. Now thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ and make it manifest the Savior of his knowledge by us in every place. What David is really saying here, he said, we are victorious in Christ Jesus.
Jesus.
We are victorious in Christ Jesus. So we don't have to worry what to say when you go in the front of that judge.
All right.
But Jesus said, don't worry what you're going to say, because my spirit will tell you exactly what to say at the right time and at the right place.
Amen.
So we are victorious in Christ.
Victorious.
We are serving a Lord that is called Yahweh Tishkanu.
All right.
The Lord our righteousness.
Glory.
Right. We are serving a God that is Yahweh Roha.
All right.
The Lord is our shepherd.
Oh, yeah.
And we shall not want.
Yeah.
Because Jesus is the one that supply every need according to his riches and purpose
oh,
in
yeah,
Christ Jesus.
You,
now let me ask you one question.
Yes.
Suppose you were standing before God right now, and the Lord would ask you, why should I let you into my heaven?
All right.
What would you tell the Lord? You see, God has a purpose for your life. For God so loved the world.
Oh, yeah.
And he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
All right.
God died for you.
Yeah.
He was buried for you, and he rose from the dead.
Oh, yeah.
You see, we have a need in our life.
Yes.
Everyone that lives on the face of this earth
oh,
has
yeah,
a need in their
right,
life. But all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Then Jesus tells us how to come to Christ.
All right.
He said, repent ye therefore and be converted,
all right,
that your sins may be blotted out.
Yes, Lord.
What does Jesus do with
thank
your sin?
God.
The scripture said that Jesus cast your sin as far as the east is from the west.
Yes.
Oh yes.
And never remember your sins
yes,
anymore.
Glory.
He said, for by grace are you saved through
yes,
faith.
Yes, yes.
Not of yourself. It is the gift of God. See, salvation is the gift of God.
Amen.
It's a gift of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And he said, you have to accept Christ. You have to believe that God is, that God died for your sin, he was buried for your sins, and he was resurrected for your sin.
Amen.
And all you have to do is say, Jesus, I believe that you died for me.
Yes.
You was buried for me.
Yes.
And you rose from the dead.
Yes.
And I want you to come and live in my heart.
All right.
And make me a new creature.
Yes,
the scripture says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
Yes.
He said, all those old things are passed
oh,
away.
Yes.
He said, behold, all things are become new.
Amen.
Jesus is our lifesaver.
Yes, he is.
He is our lifesaver.
Glory.
And there's nothing that he cannot do.
Oh, yes.
All you have to do is
that's
believe.
All right.
Yes, yes.
And all you need is faith as a grain of mustard seed.
Yeah.
And God is able to remove those mountains in your life.
Yes. Right now.
So, faith.
Thank you, Jesus.
Faith in Jesus Christ.
Thank
you, God.
Works miracles in your life.
All right.
You know why? Because Jesus, according to the Bible, is a God of signs, wonders, and miracles. And there's absolutely nothing that he cannot do.
Amen.
He said, call unto me, and I will show you great and mighty things,
you,
which your mind is not even able to comprehend.
Yes.
He said, call unto me,
thanks,
and I have the power.
Oh, yes.
I have the power to hold the stars in the existence.
Yes, Lord.
All the planets that you see.
You
say, I have the power to keep those planets from bombarding into each other.
Oh, yes.
Because I am God.
Praise
and besides me, there is no other God.
Amen.
The key to Jesus is obedience. The key, if you want God to work miracles in your life,
all right,
is the obedience to his word. Then the Lord is going to come. He's going to open the treasures. Oh, he's going to open the treasures that he have laid up for you.
All right now.
He's going to give you things that you don't even deserve.
Yeah.
You ever seen somebody that need a job? It's not qualified for that job.
Yeah.
And the Holy Spirit goes before you.
Lord.
And yeah, but when you get over there for that interview, God has already, everything is worked out because of the Spirit of the Lord.
Lord.
May God bless you and may God
thank
keep you.
Jesus.
This is what God wanted you to know.
Praise you, oh God.
Amen.
Thank you so very much for listening to our program today. The address of the church is 15640 River Road, Hinesville, Louisiana. Our service time is at 10 o'clock. The telephone number is 985-308-1425. And may the Lord to richly bless you.
If you'd like a copy of today's message on DVD in its entirety, give us a call at the number on the screen to order today. Please make reference to the title of today's message, and thank you in advance for your support.
We hope you enjoyed the message today. You can hear these kind of messages every week. Send a donation of $20 or more to Hinesville Church, Post Office Box 316, Hinesville, Louisiana, 70057. Remember, the Bible says, it is more blessed to give than to receive. May God richly bless you. Thank you.
Thank you for watching today's episode of Vision of Faith. If there is a ministry that you'd like to see featured, give us a call at 504-515-2284. That's 504-515-2284. On behalf of all of us, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.